And that is a keep. We finally got our awesome card. We'll imprint a forest since he is playing forests. And we'll be able to probably get a big guy going. There was a lot of revokes roaming the table, so he probably has one of those hiding in his pocket. You and that didn't have a mirror smith. Grr. All right. So next turn, if he doesn't kill it, we're going to have a 6/6 attacker. So it's pretty sweet. I almost feel like I want my Necropede to die, but I have nowhere to kill it. You're just gonna take the damage if that happens, so. We'll just start making a really big guy consistently attacking. Well, there isn't a fling in this format. That'd be pretty sweet. So the one play we do have is like next turn we play the goblin, and then the next turn we attack with it with the Necropede and re-equip to the goblin, and we can kill the Mirrorsmith. Ugh. Gots to be kidding me. It actually will happen right now. We're gonna get rid of that Mirrorsmith. Oh. This way he keeps his Necropede around. Ugh, that's so annoying. Alright, well, I'm gonna play Blight Mamba. And so we don't waste, even if, you know, the attack. I'm fine, actually. I'll block with this Blight Mamba. Since I can Corpse Crypt back. It is the most important creature I have because I have the Darksteel X, but he might think I won't block with it, and I definitely will. Cannot win. It's getting really silly. That Mirror Smith is just doing a lot of damage. So actually blocking with Blight Mamba means he might not take the Darksteel next turn. Or might take not he might just take the Necropede. It's really important right now to make sure that Necropede is lethal to the Mirror Smith, and now he can't re-equip it without it dying, so. Alright, well, we have dealt with the Mirror Smith. And we get back our Blight Mamba. And barring any ridiculous bomb in his hand, I feel like we've got good board. Just so we get the cantrip, well, he might, so we don't lose the guy, I'm going to give his creature protection from artifacts, which unequips a Strider Harness. Oh, but it gives him protection for my guy. Having a off night. This is a pretty awkward play. Oh man. I don't know what's wrong with me. As you can tell, if my creature was not an artifact, that was the better play. But, player of the year, right here. I do gotta tell you guys a little secret, though. When I'm playing it in a premiere event, I am not the same person as I am right now. It's like a light switch turns on. The guy is big. Wouldn't be that big if I played my turn correctly. Grr. Ugh, that was disgusting. Is it gonna get in there? Yeah, it doesn't seem like it makes much sense. We're gonna equip up the Mamba and get in with it. And then we're going to put the Zicker Claw into play. I am blocking with the Corpse Cure, just because we can chain them, and I'm not gonna try racing right now because I have such a good combo going on right now. Oh, that's bad. It's very bad. Fume Spitter. Damn. Death Touch does not really help right now. Yeah. Check if both guys lose one of them. Nah. Really what I want to do. I mean, it would make him lose Metalcraft, but then he just draws Metalcraft and I look like an idiot. And yeah, now he's not going to lose Metalcraft. What do we want to do here? Attack with both guys. Doesn't seem bad. I kind of wish we had that flying equipment. Ugh. That's the ball game. I have no real way to beat that card. Whatever, we'll try. And draw our one stinger, I guess. I think in that position it would be better to charge it up, but it's not that big of an issue. Just in case, like, I contagion engined or something. So he'd die to contagion engine anyway. Unless you know you're gonna pill Glinthawk. I mean, nah. Still get the same guys out of it. I wonder if I win that game if I don't screw up the Defiance. He went to hit Metalcraft right away. I don't know, I think I might have. So disgusted with that. There's a fume spitter we needed infinite turns ago. Yeah, this game's over. Oh my god, I just drew it.